Wasted so much time on people who should've just been ignored. If I slow down now, I'll pump the brakes. What was it all for?
What was it all for?
What was it all for? I'ma make this shit count though.
Did you have any difficult customers?
There's always the ones that are annoying, nagging. I'm one of those people, I just blow it off and keep on going. I'm not gonna let that ruin my night, is how I feel. Don't let that ruin your work day. So,
yeah.
Depends on how you handle it. But there's always that one or two.
Yeah, unfortunately, there was one or two idiots who want to mess things up for everybody.
And sometimes it can be a regular that you're just like, oh my god, he's so annoying. But you never know.
And do you have an opportunity to almost train them into conducting themselves better?
If they come in enough, you know, they kind of get used to you and your demeanor and how you act. So I guess so. The grooming of how they...
Because it's like getting twisted, man. In that environment, alcohol and what they see, men are very, you know, they're very visual beings.
Yeah, it's different.
And suggestible in those scenarios. So the touring element of it, what was the sort of in that was getting exposure, I guess more experience as well. What other kind of things did you kind of take from that? The touring element of it?
Just learning how to travel and be independent myself. Being smart and safe, making sure I'm not doing things that were stupid or dumb, because there's so many girls that just kind of go out and just say, oh, I'm going to go to the city just for a night. And no. Making sure I did things the right way, making networking and making connections actually to build my brand, and even at that time to see where I was going with all of this. So,
okay, so where were the two branches then? So one is where you are now. What was the other branch?
What do you mean?
So you're in content creation now, video wise, etc. So if you didn't go down this route, would it have been more?
I would have been.
Go on, sorry.
Nursing. I was in healthcare, so good old nursing.
You nurses, man. What on what's going on with the medical industry where, like, especially recently, you probably like the
way too many hours.
Okay, and was it what, palliative care, ICU kind of stuff, anesthetist? Like what were you doing?
ICU and geriatric.
It's a high level of stress in that job.
Yes.
So
nice to step back and say this is when I came to doing, you know, being a content creator and all of this full time was a big step to say, okay, I can do this.
So what was the reaction, family and friends? What was that kind of, or was it kind of like what you did with the stripping thing and didn't say nothing for a couple of years? Like,
for long, long time, years. So that was different because my family is very small, but very small minded at the same time.
I can understand. It's, I would struggle myself if. Like a female member of my family said, you know, hey, Uncle Noble, guess what? I'd be like, okay, why? Of all the things you could do, kind of thing. Like, I can understand, like, you know, but yeah, it's challenging. And salute for your family, you know. supporting you. I guess there would have been some trials and tribulations initially, right?
Yes, of course. But I'm doing good now, so it's different.
Yeah, you got to move different, and you got to protect them as well, protect their
Yeah.
anonymity, etc. It's
Yeah. People think we don't have lives.
Oh, Lyric, you sure? You got a life.
Know. I'm always just supposed to be online, and that's it.
But that's the fantasy, and this is what I mean by like the some men, the good old saying, you've got two brains. One's like on the top of your head and the other one, yeah. So yeah, that's it. That's it. Some men unfortunately use the smaller brain to
You said it. I didn't say it.
It's the truth. It's the truth. And on a, I think I can explain it to a point. I can explain it in two ways. From a primal standpoint, the urge for males is to procreate, is to have sex. But without protection, that is procreation, isn't it? That is replenishing the earth. So from a primal standpoint, I think that's genetically built into most males. Yeah. And then we add another few layers on, which is society and the sexualization of women, and especially now, like, come on, everywhere you go, it's just titillation, titillation, titillation. So this is this is where we are, unfortunately.
Everywhere, just
Yeah. On your food packaging, the advertisements, like everything.
it is. That's oh my gosh, that's so true. That's
But
funny, but you're on the chip guys.
yeah, the soda cans. Earth thank man, everything. Because remember, sex sells, lyrics, guys. Sex sells. So we've got to do it.
Somebody's got to do it.
Indeed, indeed. So your link, you made a link within the industry.
And got asked to be a date at an award show. So I went to the award show and was that guy's date. And I met Richard Mann that same night. Yes. So he was like, "Why are you here?" And I'm just like, "Oh, I'm just hanging out." He said, "You need to be doing more than hanging out. You look like you should be up there on the stage." So, yeah, I guess from there, he helped me kind of get my career going, starting up all my platforms and everything. He was the my in, my connect, the person that kind of helped me and oversaw me, and his network of people, Team VP. Was the group that he was in. So
Okay.
that's how I got my start in my home in the industry, really.
And he's and at that point, before the being asked to go out on the date for the award show, was you kind of leaning to like, yeah, I might think about doing these movies, because like doing these dancing and stuff, and might do some feature dancing occasionally, but that's a lot of work, man.
Oh yeah,
Yeah.
for sure. I had already looked it up and been doing research. I was on, sexy jobs, looking to see different options and how to get maybe into the industry. That's how I knew I had to have two names. It had to be Lyric Sky. So all of that, I did a lot of research before saying, like, oh, let me just go on a date to the adult industry a bit, kind of. Yeah.
Okay. Again, going back to doing the due diligence. Let's not just jump into this thing.
So
Oh,
did
it's like this is it. Oh,
huh?
it's like this is it. I didn't know. I didn't read up about it, Lyric Sky. I didn't do any research. I just thought you go there and they pay you and.
No, some people just jump head first into it and say, Okay. I'm like, girl, did you know what you're even here for?
Yeah.
So I'm the nerdy one that does the research and looks up policies and does all that for our business. But
Where do
it
you think
works out.
do you think that comes from? Sorry to interrupt. Is that based upon you your studies that you did at school, or is that just you as a person?
I would say probably school and studies is where that comes from the most, just that background of that.
Yeah. You see, I mean, going through academics, an academic process is excellent. To a point, because you can get very educated idiots who have an amazing ability to regurgitate information on the spot. Wow, that sounds excellent. But you ask that same educated idiot, go and cross that road, Max. Huh? You sure? But let me do some calculations first. Is there an experiment that's been done on that first? Like, it's like, what? So we know that there's book smarts, and there's been able to utilize those book smarts and translate that. Yeah. Totally, totally.
It's a balance.
Definitely, definitely. So yeah, you've been around the world in 80 days, quote unquote.
I know.
Booking wise, agent wise, is this all you again? Are we a one woman army, or have we got any female or male support in that area?
Booking agents and all of that. I do all my own bookings and everything together for me, myself. But I have a right hand, Carrie. She helps and like keeps me under. We work together basically. But for to say I got myself a Brazzers shoot or Reality Kings to get mainstream shoots, I didn't have an agency do that for me. It was all me. Yeah, which was hard, but I mean, you put the work in for them to see you and chime in and have professional photography and all of that. I
Yeah.
put the brand for them to see that. So it worked.
So what was the experience like working with such a major powerhouse production? Well, film company, I guess, right?
Yeah. Very interesting. Kind of the same as, I mean, we run our pro-am shoots very similar. But just a very long work day. You get there, say your call time is at 10 a.m. You might not leave until 7 p.m. It's going to be
Oh.
a long, yeah. You never know what could happen throughout the day. Hair, makeup. If you're shooting for an ad, if you're shooting for softcore, if you're shooting for international, there's all different levels of what you're shooting for that day during that shoot. People don't realize.
International. That's a new term. So what would you be doing differently to shoot internationally?
Soft core, so you can't see anything, no penetration. It's
Oh, that's what you call it. Internationally, soft core.
like hotel style porn that kind of streams on the.
Okay, I get it. I get it. I see, that's new to me. I just thought it was called soft core, isn't it?
I'm like, you do but yeah.
So yeah, that must make it doubly so in that respect. Okay, let's go there. So in that respect then, so when you are doing soft, is the male talent necessarily penetrating you while you're doing these that the internet?
It just depends, like on the male talent, because if you're shooting the scene right after, he might want to stay hard. The camera angle just needs to stay at a different angle so you can't see. You don't want him
Okay.
to go and never get hard again. So,
See, this is the thing with the male talent, man.
hardest job on set.
Yeah, man. And they don't even get paid a lot of money. Like, what the hell? Like, when I started interviewing some of these guys, or not even before I started interviewing the male talent per se, I'd be having conversations, obviously, back office. And I was appalled. I was thinking, that's wrong. That is obviously. Unless you're you want to see men, then,
Yeah.
but at the same time, you understand that there, without them being there, we're not necessarily going to be watching the woman, are we? So at least give them a little something more. Flipping out. $200, I'm hearing for some people.
Oh, they get paid very well on some of the sets. Like I know it's more than that. So I know they get
Good.
paid a good amount.
Good. Like, yeah, man. And the supplements, quote unquote, to help them perform.
Yeah. That's like a West Coast kind of thing, I guess, here in the industry.
Okay.
But I don't know. Every guy to each his own. I don't think you should have to if you're in our industry to keep up. I think it might be time to do something else if that's what you have to do.
Good
But
point. But okay. As you know, well, as you don't necessarily know, but you have more of an understanding than most women. For a woman, as you just need to sit there and look pretty. Okay? You don't even you could think this dude is the worst thing since Frankenstein, but you're paid to do something and you're gonna sell the fact that, but let's put those roles in reverse. And he's looking at someone thinking, oh my God, I've got to do that.
doesn't work. It doesn't work. It won't work.
Can't work, man. He can't. Yeah. That's why I guess.
I've seen it happen before, so
Oh, okay. So what was the end result?
male talent, he just couldn't perform because he wasn't attracted to the female talent, so we were waiting for them to get there. Seen her there partying the whole time, and he just couldn't.
This episode is sponsored by Supreme of the UK. Click the link in the description and support the broadcast.
Was that seen a no-no then, or did they get another ta male talent to come in
Yeah, you just had another male talent come in.
and would he still get paid in that respect then?
That was a thankfully not a paid, it was a trade. But no. Not if you don't complete your
The pop
contract.
shots.
Yeah, your contract duties for the day or what your script says. You're getting paid for the script to perform what's on there.
Ooh, a lot of pressure, man. And there's a lot of males, and they're thinking, oh, Lyric Sky, Mike, listen, I do for free. And they got the light boy, they got the light man signing the light man, they got the cameraman there, they got the producer back. And they think they're gonna they're gonna get down and dirty and act like a professional and satisfy maybe some of their desires and fantasies.
There are a lot of those that try. They're photographers.
Oh. Are they okay? So is that very overt from the outgo, or does it develop into that kind of scene which we've seen play out in countless old school 90s scenes?
My gosh. It comes from girls trying to get free stuff all the time. So a guy with the camera, he thinks that he could take photos of her and she's getting free photos. Then they start shooting content together. Then he thinks he can go and shoot content with everybody. It just kind of turns into a whirlwind. So it just depends. And then some of them become a bigger name than they should. It happens.
Okay.
But
There's
I don't.
all these little niches.
I know. I don't usually work. I don't work with them because I'm not trying to. I don't want to have to sleep with my photographer to get my content. I'd rather just date you because it's business. And that's
Business.
yeah.
Yes. Oh, come. It's different strokes for different folks. As they say, yeah. It's a pity because it just muddies the water. It should be. I mean, everyone I speak to, they always say this is business. This is a business. We're not going on set and everyone's having sex and all this business. And then it's like, oh, you know what? We better start filming, you know. It's not nothing like that's taking place. Everyone's like drinking 40 ounces and popping champagne, snorting stuff and all.
It's a work day, a business day.
Yeah. And now don't get it twisted. I'm pretty sure there are some low budget places where all kind of crazy stuff is taking place because that's just, you know, how they get down. But on a real business, on a proper set, I think maybe some, well, actually not even that, because I was gonna say maybe some alcohol, but a lot of women are saying no, you're not even allowed to have it. There's no alcohol allowed to say it's frowned upon, isn't it?
That's a sign that you're not under the influence of anything. And you have
Does that...
to verbally say that you're not under the influence of any alcohol. Like, you have to say it to the camera to sign off and on for compliance.
Because if they don't have that, you can then come back 25 years later and say, you know that film I did, I was actually drugged up to the hilt and I didn't know what the hell I was doing.
Exactly.
And you know, I think that type of thing, especially even just normal folk, I think that should be done. I think everyone should be videotaping or writing consent down, especially in this day and age with the Me Too and all that kind of stuff.
That's paperwork. It's not even funny. We have to have two forms of ID. Full paperwork is filled out, 2257s. It's way more than what people think. There's
Your
so much.
is it 2 weekly or monthly checks for your tests? When do you test? Is it?
Testing is usually twice a month, or more, just depending on what kind of set you're on. It just depends. More than the average person ever is what I tell people because they don't believe it.
Yeah. Now, okay, so oh, this is something I've never asked. So the test themselves, are you just literally having bloods, like a blood test, like a prick to the finger and they'll draw a little bit of blood and then they'll test you? Or is it more intimate than that when you're having these tests?
You do full lab work, so blood draw from the arm, and then you have to do a urine sample also.
Okay.
So it's an invasive test every single time we go. And people are like,
Woo.
oh. Well, I'm like, no, it's you go get blood drawn every single time.
Yeah, I hate needles. Absolutely hate. And
If you like needles, it's not a good place to be.
I take it they're taking multiple vials when they're taking these bloods, right?
Yeah, it's usually, I think, two.
Don't know. Sis, sis, like, look. You've done this. Actually, look, I'm talking to someone who's medically trained here, right? Why did I need so much of your blood to run to do muddy to run you run the tests?
There's multiple tests that they run. So a full panel has, I think, like 16 different things that
Little
they test.
slides. Yeah.
Go in and test and run a certain amount for each one.
I don't think they need 2 vials of that shit to do them tests, sis. You know what they're doing? They've got, you remember what I was talking about doppelgangers? They got you in a lab somewhere, sis. Everybody who's they're drawing all this blood. They got clones of us. Who cloned Tyrone?
Oh my gosh, that's where it's going to.
Yeah, you know, that was a bit of a jest, but it's a serious question, though. I know obviously there's a lot of stuff that's done, but it's literally just droplets of blood, the two pieces of bloody glass put together under the microscope. Let's have a look, blah blah blah. Let's get the other one. 2 vials. Sometimes, look, sis, I've been in hospital where they've taken five of those so-and-sos, and they wanted more, and I said, don't be decent. You're gonna pay me. You're gonna take more
Right.
blood, you pay me, man. This is precious stuff right here.
always feel bad. I'm like, we need more. Sorry. That was always the worst thing ever. Because they're like,
Or you have someone who's not very good at taking bloods. Oh, sorry.
yeah.
Oh, where's your vein, love?
Yes, sir.
Poking around, yeah. It's all fun. It's all fun. But look, it's all part of the experience, right?
No. Yeah.
You having, I guess you've got a higher pain threshold as well. You've been an athlete. And with
Yeah,
the surgeries.
definitely. My pain tolerance.
So genre-wise, your works. How's the best way to ask you this question? Are you known for? Do you have special talents? That's the phrase. Do you have a special talent that you're known for, or like, do you have a certain thing that, oh, that's Lyrics Guy, she does.
Nothing wild or crazy like that. I guess orgasmic oralist, since that's what I've been nominated the most for, is giving head. Yeah, I make it look really good and sound good. So
So you're like a head doctor slash head nurse. Okay.
that's what would be what I would be going for, I guess.
Okay. So let's this is I guess for the this line of questioning is now is going to be in line with the male audience, and I guess for the male audience's partners maybe. So what are the keys for your the work that you do? Like, how do you, is there practice? Is this all done on the fly kind of thing? Are you watching it being done? I think I like that move there. I'm gonna adjust it a little bit. Like, paint that picture for us, sis.
Same thing, doing your research. I watch a lot of porn to see and get a feel for kind of like either my partner that I'm supposed to work with. I go and research them and their scenes. You do a lot of pre-work if you're like, oh, if I'm shooting this type of scene, let me, get a toy that's similar or do something kind of, to prep or do things. You're not just flying into scenes willy-nilly. Your body something that you prep and take time and make sure you take care of. So, no, we're not just out here saying, okay, I think I'm going to try this today.
Indeed. So prep and plan. Prep and plan.
Yes, exactly. Just like you
Okay.
shouldn't hear.
Say that last part again, sorry. Just like.
You should in regular life. Not just film.
Sis, you're saying this, but you know what? You'd be surprised. What people should be doing in their regular life, never mind what they're doing on camera, though.
Right.
Oh man, it's yeah, man. It's I think people are gonna get quite a lot. I don't think they're gonna be surprised because I know how these interviews go. But for the ones who've never, oh my God, it's like that. And we don't need to get vulgar with the conversation at all. We just need to have a conversation to show people like, oh, it
No
isn't what
more.
you think. Yeah, it isn't what you think. I mean, and this is something that I think it's important to say as well. Even though you're in this industry, I think it's a shame that women that we've all like we shouldn't have never porn should have never been ever a thing. Pornography. We shouldn't it shouldn't even be a word. We shouldn't have access to it. We shouldn't this OnlyFans, all that kind of stuff. Now this is gonna sound as I can see it in your eyes, you're thinking, where the hell is Noble going with this? But what I'm saying is like sex is a precious and intimate thing, isn't it? It's a wonderful thing. It's a joyous thing. But we don't necessarily, I don't necessarily needed to have seen the inside of someone's womb and see them do all kind of acts. She should be doing that behind closed doors with somebody else, with 12 other people if you wanted to. But it shouldn't be a thing that we can watch per se and partake in. And then for someone's mind who's a little bit younger, who watches, especially think about it today, sis, 2023. Just think if you was 15 now and you got your phone and you thought, let's look at some of this X-rated stuff. Look at what kind of content you'd be consuming, and then that would shape your mind into that's what sex is. Sex isn't just having going to first base and then maybe doing missionary position. No. I've got to spit in your face. I've got to do all kind of weird stuff. So that's I've gone from one extreme to the other, but it would be wonderful that a woman was just able to just be who she wanted to be and didn't necessarily need to show her skills to everybody to be successful and happy.
See what you're saying.
It's idealistic, utopic world, no wars, everything's good. We've all got land and property, but unfortunately, this is not how the world is it?
No, not at all.
And there are, well, and think about it, the zombie apocalypse, as your magazine came, that gave rise to so much opportunity for young women now to do that, to take
Exactly.
control of their own financial destiny.
And create something.
Yes. So it is a positive thing, it's a powerful thing, but it is also a destructive thing in the wrong hands, just like a knife and fork we can use to eat with. And we can also attack people with it as well at its far extreme. So it's about how you use things, isn't it? It's about how you use things, moderation, balance, as we've said. And I think everyone can be can have an enjoyable life. They can have some wonderful experiences, and trustfully get to the end of the destination to where they actually wanted to get to. They may have not known at the age of 21. They may have not known at the age of 34, but the age of 50, they're like, oh, this is where I wanted to be. I did all that other stuff to prepare me to where I am now, kind of thing. Rather than getting to 50 and thinking, oh my God, I wish I'd have done that at 21. I wish I'd have went on holiday with my mates. Or I wish I would have asked that girl out and went to the club or blah blah blah. Within reason, we've got to really experience life and sometimes trip and fall to kind of learn and have that experience and think, oh well, I better not do that again. That wasn't fun. This other part of thing that I'm doing, that's fun. Oh, I like that. So yeah, man, life is a wonderful thing, man. It is a really wonderful thing. And I think moving forward for yourself, like what is the what's the plan? What's the goals?
The plan, the goal is to continue the magazine, to grow that, making sure we have opportunities to grow sponsorships, to be at AVN, to be at bigger shows and have just more production side with the ladies and roll out more products in the future.
Create an empire in essence.
Yes, exactly.
So do you have merchandise as well, or is it just the magazine? We're doing t-shirts and that kind of stuff as well.
Yeah. My t-shirt here. All the girls,
Ah, ha,
everybody that's in the magazine, all of the empresses have all the merchandise and all of that. So they always, you kind of want to be part of the club because you don't get it unless you're in. So
exclusive.
we have stickers and all kind of other little odd and end things that we give out, but merchandise, not yet, but it'll be coming. Some things will be coming soon.
Watch this space. Slowly but surely, we shall move on and progress. Sis, I've thoroughly enjoyed the conversation.
course.
Is there anything that we have missed out or you would like to promote?
No, not at all. You've touched, we've hit
We went everywhere,
every
didn't we?
everywhere.
Most definitely. Two last questions then for you as we wind down. Two last questions.
Okay.
Firstly, have you had fun?
I had a great time, yes. Thank
Excellent.
you.
I'm glad you did. I'm glad you did. And the very last question I have for you is, please tell us your name.
Okay, Lyric Sky.
Yes, okay. So that was just a joke there. So the last question for you is please tell us who you are, but do not tell us your name.
Oh.
Yeah, we're going deep now.
Okay, your sexy Texas adult film stress, and orally nominated queen.
With a big smile, ear to ear. I love it, sis. Please do throw out all your social media handles, etc. I will make sure I put them in the link below.
Okay. Instagram is Lyric Sky Official and Twitter is Lyric Sky XX. You can find everything and all of my content at lyricskyxx.com.
Excellente. What are your thoughts on Twitter? Or X as it's called now. It's a pretty wild platform, don't you think?
It's just so much diversity. It's always changing. So just keeping up with it is hard, but it's necessary for our industry.
Yes, 100%. 100%. I think Instagram needs to lighten up a little bit. I think it's like two extremes. Instagram's like, especially for your within your industry, a lot of my associates, etc., their pages are getting taken down left, right, and center for just like, what on earth? What, they're not even doing anything? You've got other people posting all kind of stuff, but you can't. Okay, but you got the other extreme, and you go to Twitter, and everything's on Twitter.
Yes, Twitter is like the dark web of porn.
Not just of porn, of everything.
Can find anything and everything you want to on Twitter.
Definitely. Wild Wild West is a good terminology for it. Again, thoroughly enjoyed the conversation, young lady. Make sure you go and follow the Instagram page. Check out the content. Jers, if my East Coast listeners are around, you can go up to Jazz and meet this young lady in person.
Yes. New
If
Jersey.
you, yeah, if you do, is there links to any of that stuff as well?
If you go on Exotica, it's EXXXOTICA, Exotica, triple X. And they
Okay.
have all the information on their website. But it's in Edison, New Jersey, November 3rd through the 5th. If you follow me, I'll be posting and blasting all kind of stuff about it too.
So that's another reason to go and follow the Instagram and see what it do, man. See what it do. Like, comment, subscribe, do all of that good stuff. Jump on the train and trust me, you enjoyed the build. Adios.
Thank you.